continues. Now, from 7 p.m. tonight, you will not be allowed to enter or leave Mombasa if you're going there, Kwale, or even Kilifi counties. This is in line with the government's directive regarding a containment of the coastal strip beginning midnight in relation to the nighttime curfew, which is already in effect. Now, this means that if you're planning to travel Wednesday morning, then you will be met by roadblocks manned by security agencies, police, GSU and the rest. Now, Coast Regional Commissioner John Elungata has reiterated that no one will be exempted from the new directives, including politicians. If you're locked out, you're locked out. And our political reporter and Coast reporter Kevin Mutai now joins us from Mombasa with the latest. Kevin, this one seems like it's a contravention of what President Uhuru Kenyatta said yesterday, because this was supposed to take effect from Wednesday, which is tomorrow. Why tonight? Why does it begin tonight?
You know, Ken, the reason why we are saying that even the security enforcement will be enforcing these regulations, these new directives from 7 p.m. is because there is the dusk to dawn curfew, which is currently in play, which begins at 7 p.m. So if you are traveling from Kilifi and perhaps you find your way at 7 o'clock here in Mombasa, then of course you'll be forced to stay somewhere here in Mombasa until 5 a.m. And that means, again, you can't leave Mombasa because the presidential directive kicks in at midnight, that is tonight. So that means if you are traveling from Mombasa or Kilifi or even in Kwale County, so you really have to do so before the curfew time because the authorities have even begun erecting roadblocks in different parts between those three counties. The three counties in the entire coastal strip contributes to 14% of the positive cases for coronavirus that have been confirmed in the country. And of course, you remember that some of those cases have infected other persons even in other counties. So the idea of partially containing this coastal strip is to avert more, the transfer of this COVID-19 infections to other people. So what we know is that only movement of cargo and essential service providers will be allowed to interact or rather cross these three counties. But we know that crucial services can that will also be affected. One of them is the ferry services. Normally, people from Kwale, Mombasa, that's the island, and even all the way to Kilifi County, normally depend on these services. Now, you know what this means is that only the ferry services will be strictly left for Mombasa residents, because that means that between the island and Likoni, so beyond there, nobody will be able to come in and access the ferry services, private vehicles, and even among other people who normally depend on these services. And of course, this morning we had a very lengthy interview with the Coast Regional Commissioner, that is John Elungata, who categorically stated that nobody at all will be spared from these new guidelines, including politicians. And he said that those who are in Nairobi as of yesterday 7 p.m. then definitely they'll not be allowed to cross over from Nairobi to access the coastal strip. But if are those, if at all there's one here in Mombasa wants to go to Lamu County, then definitely he or she will be allowed to do so before the curfew time. And of course, remember, the new guidelines starts will be enforced by midnight tonight. But just listening briefly to what the regional commissioner said with regards to the areas that the authorities will be erecting the roadblocks in the entire coast region within the three affected counties.
The three counties be locked up, mm-hmm. in the sense that if you are in Kwale, you remain in Kwale, mm-hmm. From tomorrow. Mm-hmm. If you are in Mombasa, you stay here, mm-hmm. you don't go out, you don't come in. If you are in Kilifi, mm-hmm. the same. And we intend to implement that. We have already established roadblocks. Mm-hmm. In Kilifi, we have Mabueni, we have Mtwapa, mm-hmm. We have Mazeras, mm-hmm. We have Mariakani, and we have Major Chumvi, which is on the border between Kilifi and Kwale. In Kwale, we have, of course, that Major Chumvi. Then we have Samburu. We have Kombani, mm-hmm. and we have Lungalunga. On the Mombasa side, we'll have Shikadabu. We'll have one, of course, we still have one at the ramp here at the crossing, at the Likoni ferry crossing. Mm-hmm. We'll have one in Makupa, mm-hmm. around Kibarani. Mm-hmm. Then we'll have one on Nyali Bridge at the lights area. And then we have one at Chanso. Then we'll also have one in Mtopanga, just to take care of those people we'll be crossing in from, who we want to cross in from Chonyi.
No, even as these new guidelines take place, now it will be time for the public health officers and security officers to work together in terms of tracing the contacts people who had come into contact with the confirmed positive cases for COVID-19 in this region. And this is somehow an opportunity that will help them narrow down on these cases and, of course, put them in quarantine. Among the confirmed cases we saw yesterday, the Kilifi deputy governor being arraigned and now will have to remain in custody for 3 more days, awaiting the ruling on. Remember, the office of the DPP wanted the deputy governor be detained at Manyani prison. So that will happen on Thursday. So among many other things that will definitely be looking at with regards to this new presidential directive scan, I'm sure we'll be touching on the key areas, essential services here in the coast region, and of course get some of the comments from the coastal leaders, and of course also not forgetting the common mwananchi, especially those who are working here in Mombasa and live in the neighboring counties of Kwale and Kilifi. So we'll be having a more detailed story of these new guidelines and how the residents from the coastal strip are planning to embrace the new guidelines. Back to Ken.